What's the haps? WWE Universe. I am the last professional broadcaster, Sam Roberts, back with more Elite Squad goodness. And here with me,
the first
my
professional
co-host,
broadcaster.
Well, I don't know if
the
you were the very
one. The very first one.
Of course, Johnny Broadcasting.
Yep.
Johnny Gargano of the Elite Squad. Welcome, Johnny. You got to be excited.
I'm very excited. Being the first professional broadcaster, I feel good.
I feel like you didn't invent that, but
I did.
I can't confirm. We're not here to talk about broadcasting. We don't need that in the lower third.
This is
more less about broadcasting and the order, and more about all the great figure reveals that we've got today.
We can agree
as
on
part
that.
Of the Elite
yes,
Squad.
We can agree
yes.
on that. Yes.
And Johnny.
Yes.
Today, real special. Because we got company.
Oh, we got company.
Oh, yeah. It's not just me and you doing this.
Yes. Boogie back.
Boogie is not
Boogie's
here
back.
This time. No. No. The worms are away.
Oh.
However, two of our favorite individuals from the Elite Squad here to join us from Mattel, Bill McKenna, Steve Ozer. Welcome, guys.
Hi, guys.
Thank you for having us.
What's up, guys? How you doing?
I mean, we're great.
We're doing good.
You know, we're celebrating.
We're jealous of your backdrop, but I mean,
it's incredible.
Good.
Why couldn't we all do the show from Castle Grayskull?
You look so fancy. They look very professional. Look how professional they look.
Well, we're professional too. We got a studio and, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
This isn't real brick either. It's faux brick.
All the secrets.
No, it's because, look.
This is faux brick, but that's actually Castle Grayskull.
That's the real Castle Grayskull. We're here to celebrate. Here's why it looks so fancy. Because today we are celebrating Elite 100. We got to Elite Series 100.
That's crazy to think about.
It's insane. And I don't even think people realize how insane it is. Steve, if I'm not mistaken, there's only two action figure lines that have made it to 100 waves. Of course, Elite being one. And what was the other one?
Basics, WWE Basics.
Wow. Two for two.
What an incredible milestone. And my main man here, Bill McKenna, was here since the inception of both
serious.
Of them.
He's very all business right now.
Yeah. I mean, Bill, that's a lot of designing.
It is a lot of designing.
It's a lot of designing, yeah. It's crazy to think that there's been 100 series of Elites, and I've literally designed every single one of them. That
years,
might be...
Dude.
it seems like it sometimes. It seems, you know, I had hair when I started the job.
Same here. I remember, thinking about the Elite line, I remember that you guys at Mattel came out with a bang. New Year's Day, January 1st, it was Elite Series 1, and I corralled my wife, who was only my girlfriend at the time, she stayed with me, and we started going to all the toy stores first thing in the morning on New Year's Day to find Elite Series 1. And who was
that? That's commitment.
I know.
That's why you married her.
I know.
Is that when you knew? Is that moment you're like, this is the one?
I knew. When she said, look, I found Rey. I found us a Rey Mysterio. She said, I found us a Rey Mysterio.
She said that?
I said, honey, you found me a Rey Mysterio.
Oh, you rude, kind of.
Let's see if we can find a second, kind of.
I wouldn't have married you.
But look at that. They started strong with the soft goods in Series 1. And I don't want to give away anything just yet because we're going to talk about Elite Series 100 a little bit later in the video. But before we get there, Steve and Bill, the party doesn't start there. I believe that that the Elite Squad out there asked that retros return, and you guys answered.
Yeah, of course. The retro train keeps rolling with the latest series of retros, which is available now on MattelCreations.com. And it's actually a very special wave because it's our lost wave. Celebrating that never happened orange card series from back in the day, right? This was supposed to be your set, Johnny, but build it and send it.
Productless. Come on.
Look at this. I mean, this is, for me anyway, as an old school fan of WWE action figures,
yep,
as
me
you
too.
Are, Johnny,
uh-huh. Yep.
This is my most anticipated line that the wave has had so far. This is what the retro collection is all about. Not just celebrating the superstars of today, but maybe filling in the gaps in your collection of all the legends and the superstars of yesterday. Let's start going through some of these. Of course, you can get them right now at MattelCreations.com.
We can't.
Bill can't. Yeah. They blocked us.
They say we can't get it. I came in today expecting that we're going to get this in. We're going to have product in hand. We got,
look
come
at this.
On.
This is what you're not getting.
I'm so jealous right now.
Bill's jealous. Here enjoying them, so you got Lex here.
He's showing off.
Look how happy he is.
Look how happy he is holding them in his hands.
Look at that. That's made in the USA.
Oh, boy, look at him.
Lex Luger, we have never gotten that version of Lex Luger in the retro style. We've thought about it. There's been concepts of it. There's been rumors that it was at one point supposed to exist. And Mattel has made it so for everybody except us, thanks to Bill. He's brought us made in the USA, Lex Luger, on that beautiful orange card, which is of course very symbolic to the wrestling figure.
All the little details here. You gotta appreciate the little details being wrestling.
How about Doink? Well, how about Doink? This is the later version of Doink. Steve, why don't you tell us about what makes this Doink such a cool addition to the line?
So this Doink in this gear, we only saw some artwork of this back in the day. So I don't think this ever made it to physical form that I know of. Maybe, you know, some hyper collectors out there can prove me wrong. But as far as I know, this was just artwork. So we, you know, use that as inspiration, and Bill did his own version of that classic artwork for Doink here. So really, really excited to get Doink in this orange and blue gear.
It really is amazing with this line because, you know, when you're a kid and these aren't retros, these are just the figures, one day they just disappear. Right? One day they're just off the shelves and we never see another line of them. But as the years go by, you do. You see the artwork. You start hearing about figures that could have existed, that were supposed to exist, and you want them, and they're not here, and now they are. Of course, one of them is the great Tugboat.
Yeah. That's the one you're most excited for. Yeah.
I am so excited because... of course Bill's got it. He found out I was so excited about Tugboat.
Look how proud he is to show it off.
And he's like,
he should be, but not in this form where he's trying to be. Look at how smug he looks.
Wait, he's spiteful.
Yeah, he's very spiteful.
Bill is a spiteful, sweaty guy.
Look how cool that looks in that pack. Oh, man.
That is true.
Well, if you remember, Johnny, you know, Typhoon existed as a retro figure way back in the day. But we never got the superstar that existed before Typhoon, which is Tugboat. Look at the detailing on the face. You know what he's saying? He said,
That's what he's saying. Yeah.
Is that right, Bill? Is that what he's designed? Is that what he's supposed to be saying?
Yes, that was actually sculpted from a photo of him doing the
It was worth it.
Yeah, I was always going to gift that.
you got to keep it accurate. Yeah. That's what the collectors want. Got to keep it accurate.
This is like a time machine. Seeing these figures finally exist. This is something a lot of us have been thinking about. And Johnny, I'm sure
this
is it.
This is the one.
As a kid, you're sitting there and the advertisement comes up. The Rhythm and Blues available in stores, but it was a trick, like Bill tricked us. Rhythm and Blues didn't exist in stores. And we've been waiting for decades for this figure to exist. Greg the Hammer Valentine in his Rhythm and Blues glory, and as if off the pages of WWE magazine from the early 90s, it is ripped and placed into our collections thanks to MattelCreations.com. I mean, Steve, this has got to be a major accomplishment for you guys.
I stared at that ad a million times, probably hours on end, and I wanted this Greg figure, and all of us collectively were like, what the heck happened? Where is it? Yes. It never came out. So, you know, we aim to please. We're serious about reviving retros the right way. And to do it the right way, you have to include Rhythm and Blues Greg the Hammer Valentine.
I mean, look at this. This is like...
Speaking as a wrestling figure nerd, people are going to lose their minds.
Lose their minds.
Lose their minds when they see these.
What I really love is this whole four-pack is, of course, available at MattelCreations.com. You get it in that awesome mailer that we saw, but as Bill has so spitefully shown us, they're all available individually on cards. Yep. So if you collect MOC, if you collect Loose, however you want to display them, quite frankly, I'd buy two or three.
You probably are going to.
I'm gonna have to buy two or three because I'm not getting them on the house.
No.
That's been made very, very clear. Yeah. But speaking of Mattel Creations, where all those figures are available right now.
Right now.
Coming soon to Mattel Creations is another ode to the past. Isn't that right, Steve?
That's right. We've got something really special. Our homage to the line that started it all for WWE action figures, Ultimate Edition Coliseum Collection. So we launched this late last year, which consisted of Hulk Hogan versus Terry Funk. So the follow-up is going to be, I mean, one of my favorite feuds of my early, you know, WWE fandom, Jake the Snake Roberts versus Rick Rude. And of course, you know, the packaging artwork here, an homage to that original line. Also, this opens up and it'll have your figures in there, and there's some great backdrop diorama stuff here. So you can pose your figures, do your photography, pose them on shelf. And then the figures, of course, themselves, a direct tribute to the original line from the packaging all the way down to the pack-out poses for the figures. So we remember this Rick Rude with the hands on the hips from the original line, and like how the heck do you play with it? But now you can play with it because it's got ultimate articulation and it's got, you know, all the accessories that you expect from elites and ultimates, including just for you guys, a soft goods robe. Yay! On Ravishing Rick Rude.
When you talk about playability and the fact that this has all the sort of posability of the originals, but now with all the articulation, you could pose them in any way you can imagine. We've got a really cool Elite Squad video that kind of shows all that off that I wanted to show everybody for a second. So we're talking Rude Awakening.
You can do everything.
Short arm clothesline.
You can do everything.
DDT.
Yeah.
You can do it all with these. I mean, this is...
I did a stop motion video when I was younger with my action figures. It took me like 15 hours.
Yeah.
It was a 3-second video.
Yeah. And you couldn't get half of the poses.
No.
No.
It just did this.
Can we focus on one thing there? The hip swivel on Ravishing Rick Rude. And that is thanks to a new innovation that Bill instituted in Ultimate Edition. The disjointing hips. Whoa. And if I'm using the wrong term, please correct me, but those hips pop out now. You want to demonstrate those?
Yeah, the disjointing hips, they can actually, you can pull them down so that when you can also do a much higher kick. Whoa. So the range of motion on the legs of the figures now is much greater than it was even on the Elite figures. So
wow, that's cool.
And there's something about Bill McKenna. You could always count on him making sure that those pelvic thrusts are just
big pelvic
right.
thrust guy.
He loves the pelvic
thrusts. Loves the thrust
in action figures.
Mm. Yes, but I'm sitting down today, so unfortunately, viewers are going to be cheated.
Can I just say something too?
Come see us live at Access for that.
I'll do it at Access.
Are we making that okay? Everyone out there, come to Access live to see Bill give you the thrust.
Seeing the detail that you add to these old school figures, I just saw for a moment on the Jake the Snake Roberts, the detail that is on Damien. I have never seen that much detail on a reptile with a WWE action figure.
And you ate a worm last time.
And ate a worm. I know what reptiles look like.
Yeah.
This is not just a Damien accessory or a Damien action figure. This is Ultimate Edition Damien.
Wow.
For the first time in the Mattel line, Damien is fully posable. So, you know, Jake can hold Damien up in victory, can drape Damien over his fallen opponent after he's nailed him with the DDT. So it's phenomenal. And this was a cool journey to be on with Bill as he developed this thing. It was a lot of work. So if you enjoy this Damien, give Bill a round of applause when you get it in hand, because it's something. It's really, really fun.
I'm sure everybody's been waiting for this news. I know I've been waiting for this news since I saw that this 2-pack was even first announced. We can tell you right now, this 2-pack is going to be available at MattelCreations.com starting March 1st. March 1st of this year, 2023. On March 1st, MattelCreations.com for your newest Coliseum Collection 2-pack, Jake the Snake Roberts and Ravishing Rick Rude. And Johnny, while we're talking about lines, let's talk about a line that's been white hot. Let's talk about the Legends line, and let's get to some reveals, because coming up later this year, we've got Legends Series 19.
Okay.
And there's somebody that I thought could help me and you and Steve and Bill as we discuss this. Because this is the real deal.
This is a real deal now?
Now.
Now?
Now.
Now it is?
Now. Well, it's about to be. It will be when we say hello to the legend himself, D'Lo Brown. Welcome.
You better recognize what's going on, bro.
I do. I recognize you. Yes, yes. Welcome, D'Lo. We are so happy to have you here. And the fact that all these years later, I mean, you think about your first WWE action figure and how it came out during the Attitude Era.
Yeah.
The fact that today we are still here.
Did you have it?
Of course I still had it. Of course I had it. Yeah. The fact that we're still here talking about new D'Lo Brown action figures, what's that like for you?
It's surreal. It's amazing. I mean, it's, you know, over 20 years from the first action figure to now, and the fact that there can still be an action figure of me out there relevant is pretty damn awesome. It shows the power of what the WWE is and the WWE universe. So pretty cool.
Wait till you see it.
Oh, yeah.
Let's show them. Let's reveal it. This is in Legends Series 19. Coming out later this year. Boom.
Wow.
Boom. Okay. There he is. Nation of Domination.
Wow. Holy heck.
D'Lo Brown.
That is awesome.
You can see you have the Nation gear on, of course, that you were famous for wearing as part of the Nation of Domination faction. You have the removable hat.
Yep, and?
And the chest protector. No D'Lo Brown action figure would be complete without that chest protector. I mean, D'Lo, what are you thinking?
That is awesome. I want one right now. Get me one right now. That's how badass that is.
Bill's got one. Look,
Bill's got one right now.
I want one right now, too. We don't have them.
I'll keep in touch. But this is actually the first factory sample that I just received. I'm still evaluating it for to make sure that when the final product comes out, it's as good as possible. But I just wanted to, you know, I thought it was pretty excited that we had
that
this.
That looks so good.
And Bill, if I'm not mistaken, isn't that gear very similar to the gear that the first D'Lo Brown action figure ever was wearing?
Yes, it is. Yes. It's based off his time in the Nation of Domination, which, you know, I think everyone that was watching at the time remembers very fondly. I know I do. So I wanted to, when the opportunity came to put D'Lo Brown back in our lineup, to make sure that he was wearing the Nation of Domination outfit this time.
Well, D'Lo, you know, you think, what could possibly
be better than
a figure in the Legends line?
Yeah, what's better than that?
I can take a guess.
What do you think?
I think two figures in the Legends line, because you're the chase, dude.
Yeah.
D'Lo, you are the chase in the Legends line.
Holy.
This is advanced into your WWE run.
Yep.
The blue
yep.
and the black gear, of course, still with the chest protector. But D'Lo, you will be available to the WWE Elite Squad in both sets of gear for everybody to find on Target shelves.
I'm telling you right now, I'm up for someone who talks for a living. I am speechless because I have two action figures in this line. I cannot believe it. This is awesome.
I mean, you know, you think about the D'Lo Brown memories, and of course you think about being the Eurocontinental champion.
Yeah.
You think of all this stuff, but when you go back early, in the beginning of the WWE run, and you think about taking that Pearl River plunge on the roof of a car, you had to ask yourself, as you sat there in all that physical pain, is it worth it? 20 years later, when you look at these two action figures, I think I know the answer. D'Lo, is it worth it?
It every second was worth it. And to sit here and look at those two action figures coming out later on this fall, man, my heart is huge right now. I'm smiling from ear to ear. I can't believe it.
Look at that. Two distinct eras of D'Lo Brown represented. So cool. I can't wait to have much more D'Lo in my collection.
Yeah, definitely.
D'Lo, while we got you here, I'd love to show you some of the people that you'll be sharing that Legends line with, if you want to take a look at some of the other figures.
Absolutely.
Yeah. That'll be a part. Look at that. Right alongside you on shelves will be Kama Mustafa. You can pick up D'Lo and Kama Mustafa for the first time in his Nation of Domination gear, complete with all the detailing, all the tattoos, extra hands, removable hat. There he is. Steve's holding him up there, D'Lo. That's so cool.
That's awesome. I can't wait to call you know, Big Papa and tell him we're going to be together again in a series. That's awesome.
Wow. Oh, it looks like we got a vest, too. Is that a vest?
It looks like a vest.
Entrance vest, yeah.
I mean,
so now everyone's Nations in action figure form will finally be complete with this Nation D'Lo and Kama figure. So we're super stoked for that.
Yes, my Nation of Domination shelf will finally be accurate. D'Lo, I mean, when you think about the success of the Nation of Domination, you know, you couldn't have known how well it was going to work when the group of you would come to the ring, but you'd hear those reactions. Is there any specific Nation of Domination memory that you have that you think like, man, this is working?
There were times when you would just walk out there, you could feel the electricity. There's the famous moment where The Rock is wrestling Steve Austin and I get stunned on top of the truck. Yep. Feel the electricity happening while we're in the midst of that, and probably one of my favorite moments.
That's awesome. And you've surely got an elite Stone Cold Steve Austin by now.
Yeah.
You can get the Mattel Wreckin' Rig.
Oh,
so
yeah,
you got a
sure.
truck.
Wow.
And now you're going to have elite D'Lo in Nation gear. You can literally reenact it. But we're not done. We got D'Lo.
Uh-huh.
We got Kama Mustafa.
Uh-huh.
Guess who's joining him in the Legends line?
Who we got?
Undertaker.
Oh.
Undertaker joins you on shows. And of course, this is from the Undertaker's WWE Championship title run. And Bill, if I'm not mistaken, this is the first time that hat has been in action figure form. That sort of flat, wide brim.
Oh, looks cool.
Yeah, yeah, Attitude Era hat. Is that right, Bill?
Absolutely, yeah. This is the hat that Undertaker wore sort of at the beginning of the Attitude Era. That was very, you know, as someone who was watching a lot at the time, it was very distinct to me, and I always wondered why it was never sort of recreated on an action figure. So I guess it was up to me to recreate it on an action figure.
I love that. That's what I love about the Legends line, that somebody like Bill can go, why is this never made into an action figure? I'm gonna make it into an action figure.
It's like the Thanos meme. Fine, I'll do it myself.
Yeah.
That's Bill. Yeah. Bill is Thanos.
No. Yeah. Well, who is it? Who's the fourth member of Legend Series 19? Hey, we did it!
We did it!
Brother Love.
Look at that.
First time in the line, Brother Love finally comes to the Mattel's Elite Collection in Series 19.
Oh, we got him.
Oh, Steve, you got a Brother Love?
Yeah, he went home with me.
So, good.
So, you know, obviously we wanted to have someone compliment the Undertaker, just like Kama compliments D'Lo in this wave. So we thought, why not the Undertaker's manager? But not just any manager, his first manager, Brother Love. So this is Brother Love's first Mattel figure, one of the most requested figures to be included in our line. So it's finally happening. So thank you to Bruce for allowing this to happen. Today's the first time seeing this, and I've wanted this for a long time, and I'm blown away. The Book of Love, the Brother Love specific microphone, it's incredible. I can't wait for everyone to get this Brother Love figure.
I hope you guys at Mattel have plenty of red paint, because that is a bright face on Brother Love.
The red really makes the white suit pop.
Yeah, it does.
It's a pop.
Yeah, it does. D'Lo, before we let you go, now that you've seen both of your figures as part of Legends 19, where does this rank in the pantheon of D'Lo Brown action figures?
They will be the top two action figures, and I cannot wait to get my hands on them, and I can't wait for them to get out to the public. Those are badass.
That's fantastic. Well, D'Lo, we appreciate you spending a little time with us. Super happy to be able to reveal those figures to you. They'll be available later this year on shelves at Target and at Target.com. So be on the lookout for them and scoop them up. Thanks, D'Lo. We've enjoyed talking to you.
Appreciate you guys. Thank you. Awesome talking to you guys. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Johnny, as exciting as all of this has been.
Very exciting.
We told you at the beginning of the show that we're here for a reason. And it's time, baby.
Let's see it.
Elite.
One hundo.
And before we show you the figures, let's take a look at this video to see what we're about to see. Big shout out to Battle Stories for making that and all of the awesome stop motion animation that we've been seeing on the show today. Now, before we get to Elite 100,
You keep hyping it up. And then, wait.
Teases. I love a tease. I love teases. And we got another tease, but this one, this is a biggie. He's part of Elite 100.
Okay.
But he was also part of Elite Number One. He's the greatest masked superstar of all time. Here to give us a couple words as we head towards Elite 100, Rey Mysterio.
¿Qué pasó? ¿Qué pasó? What's happening, WWE Universe? This is WWE superstar Rey Mysterio, and I am here to say congratulations to Mattel on Elite Collection 100. 100. Así es. This is a huge milestone, and thank you for making me a part of it. Una bendición. Now, I remember being represented as an action figure in Elite Collection Series number one, el número uno, and to still be here for number 100 is something truly especial, very special. The Elite 100 Rey Mysterio represents my time in WCW, which was really special, and comes with the WCW Cruiserweight Championship, a title that is appearing for the first time in the Elite line. That title meant the world to me. Now, thank you to all the fans and collectors out there. Pick up Elite 100, Rey Mysterio, and the rest of the set at Ringside Collectibles. Pero ya, booyaka.
Rey has had about 15 mainline Elite figures, not counting pay-per-view, not counting store exclusives, not counting two packs. He's had so many figures. He's probably, I will say, easily, maybe one of the most represented figures in the Elite line.
Let me tell you something. We throw the word toyetic around
quite a bit.
Rey Mysterio is toyetic.
The definition of toyetic.
Yes.
When I was a little kid, I wanted to make a Rey Mysterio mask to wear.
You did?
I made it out of like paper mache.
Was it as good?
No, it was bad.
No.
It was very bad. I did a bad job.
Okay. Well, I'm sorry that you did it. Hey, look. Let's not wait a second longer. It's time, Johnny Gargano.
Finally, no more teases.
No more teases.
We're in it.
For Elite 100.
Here we go.
And
drum roll.
Steve and Bill, you guys got to be so psyched that we've gotten to Elite 100.
I can't believe it. You told your story earlier of waking up on New Year's Day and heading out to stores to find Elite Series 1, and I did the same thing. But my, relationship didn't work out the same way as yours did, so congratulations on that. But I got all the figures, so that's the main thing, right? I got all of Elite 1, Day 1, New Year's Day in 2010. But Bill here, as I mentioned earlier, has been here from the start, working on these figures. So, how incredible to hit Series 100 finally.
It's kind of amazing to think about again, as I said earlier, just that they kept me around this long.
It's an emotional time for all of us.
Yeah, it's hard to believe. I've been literally doing this for close to 15 years now. At this point, over 100 series. We're just releasing Elite 100. And who knows how long this could go on. We 10 years from now, we could be talking about Elite 200. And, you know, hopefully I'm still here.
You know what, Bill? If you get your design fingers on, I bet we could do it in 5 years. Wow. But before we get there, yes, let's talk about these figures, okay? Because you talk about the talent that you've gotten to work on, and that's kind of what makes this line so unique. Not only is it a celebration of all the talent, but all these champions have new championship titles that come with them. Let's start with the one and only Rey Mysterio, the master of the 619. He is here, and he is representing his time in WCW as...
The WCW Cruiserweight Championship. Beautiful title, by the way. Yes. Very underrated title.
Absolutely very underrated title. Rey Mysterio in his... a lot of people talk about the NWO and how influential... I'm going to open this up, by the way.
Oh, do it.
How influential the NWO was. But to me, the Cruiserweights... In WCW, if you look at the way wrestling looks today and WWE looks today, I think the Cruiserweights were just as impactful, if not more so. And Rey Mysterio, wow, is the guy that represents them most of all. Look at the detail in this, Johnny. I mean, with the pink and the yellow, the fully colored.
Beautiful.
WCW Cruiserweight Championship. You can see the lace on the back of the mask. So
the little cool details as well, with the little articulation on the wristbands as well.
Oh yeah, and you can see the way
they're not
earlier.
Just painted on,
the way Bill
sculpted on.
Bill talked about making specific hands for Brother Love. He made those specific wristbands.
Look, they're also not hard either. A little bendy, so they would be like normal straps as well on his wristbands.
Almost soft goods.
Yes, almost.
One of the important details on Rey's mask in WCW was he had the little cutout under the nose, the nostrils, and that's not something we've never sort of represented on our figures before. Elite 100 Rey. It's a little. Because of the red color with Rey's flesh, it's not quite as noticeable as if the mask would have been like a yellow or a blue, but we definitely have that represented on this figure.
That is so cool. I mean, Bill, where does this rank in your Rey Mysterio designs? When you get to design Rey Mysterio, this version of Rey, where does it rank?
This is high because this is from when I was sort of, again, also being a fan of WCW Cruiserweight Division at the time, you know, first getting familiar with Rey Mysterio and just like, the guy was, he's mind blowing still, but like, you know, he was doing stuff that's like, not only had you never seen before, but it's like, I couldn't even believe like it was even possible. So being able to, you know, represent that portion of his career in an action figure, you know, it's special to me as someone who collects this stuff and watched at the time.
He really set the tone for a whole generation of all of us.
And he's still doing it.
Still doing it.
He's still doing it. Well, Speaking of stuff that you've never seen before, how about when this individual got onto the scene for the first time? Andre the Giant as part of Elite 100. And this one's really special, Johnny, because he's suited Andre.
He's suited Andre.
Which we haven't really seen in this form before. This is the suit that he wore on Piper's Pit when he ripped the cross. Ooh, off of Hulk Hogan's
got it in
neck
his hand as well.
That's right. Not only does he come with the cross that he ripped off of Hogan's neck, but he comes with this Andre the Giant specially made WWE championship that is extra long so it can fit around the waist of the Giant. I mean, talk about iconic times in WWE. WrestleMania 3 is right there. And I mean, Steve, as big of a super fan as you are, to be a part of putting out a figure that exemplifies the buildup to WrestleMania 3 like this had to be a thrill.
Who knew Andre the Giant in a suit would be one of the most talked about figures in Elite 100, but here it is, and it is, and it's very impressive. So hats off to you, Bill, for killing it with this one.
Thank you. I want to give hats off to our production team that was able to transfer the pattern of the checker pattern on the suit jacket onto the figure, because it's a seamless reproduction. This is not easy to do, to get all the pattern to line up with squares this small and precisely placed. I've never seen a figure that's able to do it as well as this one.
Yeah.
And I've seen a lot.
And you guys had to know that a suited Andre would be popular because this is the chase in Elite 100. And this is a really cool one because not only does he come with everything that the first one does, the extra hands, the Hogan cross, the championship title, but the color change in this figure is very cool because at first I'm looking at this going, oh, this is kind of a tip of the hat to the Rock and Wrestling cartoon.
Yep.
But I've looked and people have done their research and it looks like Andre was actually wearing something very similar to this for the WrestleMania 3 contract signing. You remember table?
Yep.
Steve, are both of those true?
They're both true. Wow. Bill and I, both fans of Hulk Hogan's Rock and Wrestling, so, you know, this particular suit was featured on that cartoon. But, you know, for those people who are, you know, sticklers for accuracy to content, it's content accurate. He wore this on Piper's Pit. I think he wore it when this title was presented to him. And as you mentioned, the contract signing as well. So this suit was in regular rotation for Andre at the time.
I think that's right. Well, you can get both as part of Elite 100. Of course, the turquoise jacket is the chase figure.
Yeah.
But talking about chasing things down and legacy and legend, how about The Rock? The Rock is a part of Elite 100. And it's a very special version of The Rock because not only does it encompass the Attitude Era, of course, the football jersey.
Jersey is very popular during that time.
Oh, we all remember.
Oh, yeah.
All remember this football jersey. But what's really cool is, and we talked about this a little bit, right, with the retro figures, that there was a legend that this existed somewhere, mm-hmm. but we can never find it. There was always this legend after the Smoking Skull Championship came out that The Rock was going to get his own custom championship, and pictures and stuff would pop up here and there. Later on, years later, we saw online that it did exist, that it was produced. It was never on television. But the Brahma Bull Championship was a real thing that was really produced. Obviously, they took reference photos of it.
Of course.
Because Bill got his hands on them.
Bill loves reference photos.
Loves them.
Sure,
and he has made
it,
believe it or not, into figure form. We are getting the Brahma Bull Championship. We are righting the wrong. Many people saw it as a wrong.
And it's true.
That The Rock never got his own championship. Mattel is writing that wrong. What was the decision like for you guys to say, you know what? I know it was never technically on television when The Rock was champion, but the Brahma Bull title needs to make it into the Elite line.
For something seemingly so obscure, boy, people sure knew about it and have been demanding it and bringing it up for a long time. So, you know, there's something there, and we wanted to bring it to life in this line since we were doing all new titles for every superstar. So how appropriate for Rock to get this very special title.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely so cool to have that in figure form.
I do appreciate the fact that you guys can just kind of make anything come to life as well.
Yeah.
Anything that was a reference photo or talked about or a possibility, you bring it to life in figure form. And that's the coolest thing in the world.
That's what's so cool about having guys like Bill and Steve, and I hate to blow some smoke, but they're real fans.
That's the best part of it.
And so they kind of get the appeal and what fans are into.
It's all of us wrestling nerds talking about and making wrestling figures for wrestling nerds, which is great.
That's it. And, you know, who's not a nerd?
Who's not a nerd?
The king of cool, John Cena.
Oh.
John Cena here as part of Elite 100. I knew I'd find my way there.
Yeah, you got there.
As part of Elite 100, of course, the chain gang soldier, John Cena. He's got the necklace. He's got the hat. He's got his hands. But what makes this unique and very, very special to Elite 100 is that Bill and his engineering brain figured out a way to do it. I'm gonna open this one up because you're gonna be excited about this, Johnny.
Yeah, I don't know about this yet. I'm going in blind. I purposely do this.
We've had this title before, but this one, Johnny.
It spins. Wow.
We got a spinner that really spins. Bill, you gotta be happy. You said we gotta figure out a way to bring the spinner to the Elite line. And here it is. This is cool.
Yeah, this is something I've wanted in the line from the start when we started doing the titles. You know, what better place than Elite 100 to finally get this spinning title into the lineup?
Yeah, and there it is, perfectly representing him, perfectly representing John Cena with the hat and everything. Speaking of just absolute legends, how about the man? How about Becky Lynch coming to Elite 100? And you see Becky Lynch in her iconic white gear with the extra hands, with the highly detailed,
very detailed,
studded jacket. Look
you
at all the
see
studs
this thing in person
on this thing. And a newly, if I'm not mistaken, Stephen Bill, resized SmackDown Women's Championship that is now the perfect size for your Mattel Women's Division. Is that right?
Of course. You know, we heard the cries of give the female figures their own unique version of the title. So we wanted to deliver, and here it is, brand new, first up with Becky, and then you'll see this rolled out to our future women figures as time goes by. But Becky gets it first because she's the man. Perfect size for our Mattel Women WWE action figures.
Yes, and who better than Becky? Who better than Becky to debut that? The man, big time Bex. Well, rounding out this one, I am super, super excited about.
I know about this one. Yeah, this is a...
Rounding out Elite Series 100, of course, you look at the icons in this line. Steve Austin.
You got to start somewhere.
Is the man that rounds it out. Yeah. But it's not just any Steve. Stunning Steve Austin comes to Mattel's Elite line in Elite Series 100. And this is just a beautifully designed figure. He's got his long flowing locks, which you don't see too often in figure form. He's got his, of course, multicolored trunks design, which I think Steve Austin himself has said is very ugly.
No, they're beautiful.
And of course, speaking of beautiful, he's got the soft goods.
Soft goods.
Fabric robe, ring robe, and first time in the line, obviously, the television championship that he comes with, also in red. I mean, so cool. Johnny, you remember growing up and watching Stunning Steve?
I do. And the fact that we get this figure now is pretty insane to me, honestly. And, of course, the soft goods. Can't say enough great things about soft goods.
They're so great, these soft
they're
goods.
They're so soft. And
yeah, and they're good.
They're so good.
They're really good. What was the decision-making like, right? I would imagine you guys go, well, Steve Austin has to be in this line. How did you guys land on not only Stunning Steve, but this early era Stunning Steve?
I think some of it was because of the theme of the lineup was the brand new title for everyone in the assortment. And we had already done the Smoking Skull title. We had already done the Attitude Era title, obviously the Winged Eagle title. But what title haven't we done for Steve Austin? Well, as Stunning Steve Austin, he held the WCW TV title. And that, I remember at the time watching at because of the red strap and the silver plates. Like, it was a very distinct visual title. It's something I've wanted on a figure for a while, just finding, you know, what's the right place to do it. You know, and so when it was decided that Steve Austin would be in Elite 100, you know, that this might work out, you know, to, you know, not necessarily do Stone Cold Steve Austin, but do a Stunning Steve Austin, which has never, I don't know if there's ever been a Stunning Steve Austin, you know, with long blonde hair.
I don't think so.
It's kind of a gap in your it's kind of like the start of Steve Austin as a figure collector. When you do your chronological collection, you know, it didn't really have a starting point, and now it does.
So cool. What a way to round out one of the coolest lines in the history of Mattel's Elite Collection. And how fitting, Elite Series 100. Steve, Bill, we want to thank you for bringing the knowledge and helping create a line that's this special. But you know, one of the things that makes this line so special that we haven't even talked about yet is the incredible, unique packaging. Really cool packaging for Elite 100. And here to talk to us about that is Mattel's lead packaging designer, George Martinez. George, how you doing, man?
I'm doing great. I'm excited. Is this like my first cameo? Am I part of the Elite Squad now? Am I officially part of it?
Yeah, I think so. We can make that
Do we have jurisdiction?
I think so.
Okay,
right?
I think so.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, 100%.
Yeah, for sure.
Awesome.
I mean, especially after the packaging that you've done, and I want to talk to you more about it because it's so cool. But I also want to talk to the person who's responsible for some of the actual art on here, because Mattel brought in, this is so cool,
yep,
Jonathan Bartlett, who did a lot of the very unique artwork that you see featured on the packaging. Welcome, Jonathan. How are you doing, man?
Hey, I'm doing great. It's awesome to be here. It's like being a part of this is, I'm still pinching myself a little bit. You know, it's quite the milestone, and to get the trust of the team to bring my artwork to this is like a whole other level of.
You want to be a part of the Elite Squad too?
Can we do that?
I think so.
Count me in, please. Yeah, yes.
You caught him on a good day because
you're part of the Elite Squad. You're part of the Elite Squad. You're not a part of the Elite Squad. What? You're part of the Elite Squad.
What? I mean, you're just handing out cards.
It's transferable.
Okay, we didn't have to. Well, before we
two for one deal.
Right, before we figure all that out.
Yeah.
I think I can say. But before we figure all that out, can you guys talk about the journey that you took to get this packaging done? I mean, what was that like?
It all started on how can we align this for the fan, the collector, WWE Universe. And it all started with this packaging, if you guys remember this here.
Yes,
our first milestone, right? We alluded to this at the beginning, right? Series 100 basics. So it was thinking as far as like, how can we make this a part of this milestone, right? It all has to go together. There's a thought process on every line that we do. And so from here, we ended up here. And you guys shown the packaging already. And it was how to pair these guys up, right? We got the platinum and black, very nicely matching up. But not only that, we had to bring in a special artist, Jonathan Bartlett, to spruce this up, to level it up.
Yeah, I mean, I don't even know where to begin with in terms of what my role was here. Like I had said in the very first thing, it was being given the trust. I knew 100 was coming up, just being a fan of the action figures and everything WWE essentially. But I hadn't given any thought that like, wow, maybe this would be the moment when something could coalesce, and it did. So it was awesome. It's been great. You know, working with George specifically, I was thinking about this. I was like, well, in wrestling terms, but I feel like we are a tag team a bit on this. I don't know which tag team, but we are.
Demolition.
Demolition.
Choice.
Yeah. Okay.
I think probably because Demolition. You know, they were colorful. Uh-huh. They were aesthetic. They used paint. I think so. I mean, Johnny, you know.
Yeah.
How important it is for a superstar to have the aesthetic right. You
definitely
work very hard. I mean, you work so hard
on
your gear and presenting yourself in the right way. How do you feel about the representations that these superstars have on the packaging?
His artwork's incredible.
Yeah.
Dare I say, it's more stunning than Stunning Steve Austin, which
is very stunning.
Very stunning, but more stunning, I think, is his artwork.
We do have some things that are not traditional to our Elite line that we were able to introduce into this Elite One Series 100, and that is we have a nice little foil there for some flair, right?
Oh,
and
yeah.
We also have these unique back cards.
The card backs, yeah.
That are not,
you got one right there.
Are not traditional to our Elite. And so these pair up nicely to each individual superstar, never been done before, and that's a way to celebrate the artwork that Jonathan brought to this Elite line.
That's perfect. Well, thank you guys so much. This is very cool, and I love how much went into this. It's Series 100, and that's the way it should be. So thank you guys.
Absolutely.
All right. Well, Johnny, I mean, we have done so much here today.
Yeah,
a lot was accomplished.
We accomplished a lot today.
We've made it to Elite 100. I feel like we were only at Elite 1 when we started, but we got to Elite 100.
That's how that works, by the way.
Is that how
it starts at 1 and then it goes to 100?
All the way up.
Yeah.
Got it.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Well, I'm gonna make a note of that.
It's math.
For the next time, we appreciate everybody at Mattel, Steve and Bill, for joining us. Everybody from WWE to D'Lo Brown, even my Elite Squad sidekick, Johnny Gargano.
The first professional broadcaster.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know. Again, not good with numbers. We also appreciate all of you for hanging out. Don't forget, all of you can get Elite Series 100 at Ringside Collectibles. Once you get them, make sure you keep going with your WWE figure photography. Hashtag WWE Elite Squad. And we'll see you next time. We meet again for the Elite Squad.